Hey everybody, Lance Koike here. Today we're going to talk about rep ranges for hypertrophy. So yesterday we talked about strength ranges. We talked about that 1 to 6 rep range that really gets those total motor unit recruitment, uses all my muscle fibers, and allows me to lift more weight. Now, with hypertrophy, the goal is not necessarily to lift more weight, though that tends to happen as a byproduct. The goal is to build more muscle. And so that can be associated, like there is going to be a positive correlation with more muscle and more weight on the bar in general. But you have to be, you have to test it really well. So like if I do my bench press first thing on 4 weeks of workouts, and then I go in and I do it second thing after I've done like, pre-fatigued with some chest flies. Now, it seems kind of obvious to us if we take a step back, but you're not going to be benching the same amount of weight, even though you have more muscle 4 weeks later, even though you're stronger 4 weeks later, if you're pre-fatiguing the muscle, right? So if I introduce that pre-fatigued with like some dumbbell flies or something, then I try to bench after that, I'm going to get hypertrophy stimulus. I'm going to build muscle, but my testing, I'm not going to look quite as strong. Testing is a bad word. My measurement during my actual training sessions is going to look like I'm getting weaker, right? And so you have to be able to understand that. You have to be able to say, doing bench press after pre-fatiguing with a chest fly is a different exercise. It's not the same bench press. And so I'm going to measure myself based on how I do my bench press in this given context, rather than saying, normally I can do 275. I'm so weak. Okay. So we need to look at that very appropriately. Now, the FAST rule, the rep range for hypertrophy, generally goes down to about 6 reps, and then it generally goes up to about 12 reps. Now that is just a somewhat arbitrary rule. You can get muscle hypertrophy by doing 15 reps. You could probably get it by doing 20 or 25 reps, as long as you couldn't do 26 reps, if you know what I mean, right? And that pulls us back to what we said yesterday in our strength rep ranges video. The issue is I need to push myself to my maximal abilities, right? I need to get to that. When I use this rep range, it's not just that I'm using a really easy weight for this rep range. It's that I'm using a really hard, really challenging weight in this rep range. And that's what gives me the adaptation that I'm looking for. If I choose this particular rep range, or we might say if I choose this intensity, that will allow me to get the adaptation that I'm seeking. So maximal effort for 6 reps is going to give me a little bit of strength, a little bit of hypertrophy. Maximal effort for 3 reps is going to give me a lot of strength. Maximal effort for 8 reps is going to give me a lot of hypertrophy. For 12 reps, for 10 reps, for even kind of 15 reps, though that's not part of our rule, there's some overlap. And we'll get into the other rep ranges here in the coming days. Hopefully those rep ranges, that 6 to 12 rep intensity kind of scheme works for you. Hopefully that is making sense.